these White House rumors are persisting. Martha Mitchell's crazy. Martha Mitchell's an alcoholic. Martha Mitchell's this. Martha Mitchell's that. And of course, they just kept on.
The party to whom I am speaking? Oh, it's Mrs. Mitchell. Oh, I wasn't aware that you had a husband. Mrs. Mitchell, I have a work order here before.
Then I wasn't just the Attorney General's wife, nor the campaign manager's wife. I was one of the first three in what we have now termed CREEP, which was a committee to re-elect the president.
The break-in of the Democratic
I was brainwashed. I was told that this is what goes on in campaigns.
I've never talked to her yet, but what I haven't gotten a good news story, so I automatically, she was in California, and the Democratic headquarters alleged bugging incident had broken out, and that was my immediate question, well, what do you think about that? And she said, I've given John an ultimatum. This really set her off.
He said, Fred, Miss Mitchell's on the phone with Helen Thomas. She's telling her a bunch of stuff about Watergate. And I said, well, she really doesn't know anything about Watergate. And he said, well, she's telling her a bunch of stuff anyway. What should I do? I said, well, just go pull the phone out of the wall.
And pretty soon, I mean, we weren't into a conversation, but I heard her saying, get away, get away. And I didn't know what was happening, and then there was a phone disconnect.
Incredible. It's
true.
Like reading a James Bond novel. You can't believe it. I can't believe what's happened to me.
And he was not too perturbed. He said, I love that little girl. He said, so it seemed that everything was going to be all right.
My husband has done everything to protect Mr. President. They have all let him down. They have all gotten away from the good people.
You mean let Mr. Nixon down or let Mr. Mitchell down?
Mr. Mitchell has become the fall guy.
Well, I just don't sit around and do nothing, I guess. I'm a doer. I'm always up to something.
Maybe it's good, maybe it's bad, but I'm always up to something. The only thing that John Mitchell got mad about, and I think perhaps he got a little back talk from the White House, was when I was the first one, if you recall, said that I thought that Mr. President should resign. Well, John did get mad at that.
Mr. Mitchell's reactions to the televised hearings are the same that I'm telling you, that Mr. Mitchell and I went to Washington to help this country. We didn't profit one iota from anything. Nothing. And I've been mean to you all, and I'm sorry, but I've been mean to you on purpose because I am sick and tired of people saying I'm after publicity. But if I have to get publicity in order to clear two guiltless people, my husband and myself, and you can place all the blame right on the White House, and if you've got any sense at all, you'll go out and find out. Mr. President, he has been protected under no uncertain circumstances. And as I told you a few minutes ago, that when I asked him, he said to me that if anything happened to Mr. President, the whole country would fall apart. And if you remember, a few weeks ago I suggested that Mr. President resign. Well, it's a darn better idea that he resign than be impeached.
As far as John Mitchell's concerned, as I said the other night, in the States, he's dead. Absolutely dead. He doesn't exist.
In fact, I can't understand why. I thought I was a little bit more astute than I had been. I don't know why that I didn't realize to some extent what was going on, but I didn't. I took everybody, I was brainwashed, as everybody says to me now. Don't you realize you were used? Yes, I was used. I have to get myself back into a train of thought where I'm not so emotionally involved, you see. I have to do a documentary on the whole thing, to analyze it, to put it in perspective. It's not a question of Martha Mitchell being able to go out and say, why did this husband of yours do such a thing? When you're emotionally involved, it takes on, everything takes on you.
Say I know anything, and this I would tell the Senate Watergate Committee if they ever asked to see me again, was that I am now so confused by what I've read, what I've heard, what I've seen, what I couldn't be a good witness. Not in the slightest.
The most important thing is that I think American people should know that I've been under the most trying things, and if anybody could turn out to be an alcoholic, I should.
The loquacious, witty, and charming wife of the former Attorney General, Mrs. Martha Mitchell.
Oh.
Thank you.
Good evening to you, Dickie. And I am here to say that my John is not taking the fall, because Martha is here to spill it all.
Well, you certainly seem to be in good spirits tonight.
Oh, honey, I'm always in good spirits.
Excuse me, I don't mean to digress, but there's a man over there in the wings with a crew cut and a dark suit. Is he your bodyguard?
Are you kidding me, honey? He is working for them. Why, he's got a needle that he's ready to shove in my derriere the first time I bend over. Mean-looking dude.
As far as Richard Nixon's concerned, I'd rather not comment.
Thank you.
just kind of living from day to day because I had no idea in this world that anything would ever happen to me like this. Ever. My wildest dreams, I couldn't imagine.
And the light is hanging to train you now. That you were the one to blame, shut up. Don't you give us any lip, just run. You could give those guys a slip.
All right, Isabel, here's the scoop.